Do you know what the top Google search result for Geometry Dash is? Maybe it's the game's Steam page?
Wow, this video turned out great! An exposal of a fake Geometry Dash website and how it's stealing popular Scratch projects. It's a good thing I never have to think about this ever again.
It all makes sense!
Craig, is that you? No one's heard from you in weeks, ever since you started rambling about that fake Geometry Dash.
What do you know about fake Geometry Dash? Do you have any idea what I've been through? One Games, Geometry Light, Egg Dash?
What are you talking about? You're not making any sense.
Oh, trust me, I am! There is so much to uncover. Come here, I'll tell you everything. And I mean everything.
So, a while back I made a video where I investigated those fake Geometry Dash websites you might have seen. Long story short, they take advantage of the fact that Geometry Dash is a game you have to install through the App Store or Steam or whatever. However, there's a surprisingly large demographic, mostly children, that think that you can just search the game up on Google and immediately start playing, no download required. Alternatively, maybe they just have a device like a Chromebook where they can't install Geometry Dash. So what these sites do is simple. They call themselves Geometry Dash, work their way up Google search, and then when someone clicks on it, they have a Geometry Dash to play, usually with a ton of ads where all the money goes to the website and none goes to RobTop, the developer of the game. In other words, it's a scam and you shouldn't fall for it. Now, obviously, you can't just put actual Geometry Dash on a website. Porting this game to a web browser would probably require remaking it from the ground up. Fortunately, some people have actually done this. The majority of these websites would present you with Geometry Dash V1.5, a remake of the game made in the building block programming language Scratch by the legend himself, Griffpatch. But although it's impressive for Scratch standards, you can't really pass this off as the real thing. But to the people foolish enough to think that they're playing real Geometry Dash on a website, this was enough. Scratch Geometry Dash actually came with a level editor, so it would go on to develop a bit of a community. People would remix it and build their own levels, and others would go on to add new objects and mechanics. One scratcher in particular, iPhone AT&T Time Warner Cable 115, made it their mission to remake as many real GD levels in Scratch as possible, from level easy to change of scene to everything in between them. No lie, there's literally thousands. Are they good? Not really, in fact most are barely even playable, but I see it as more of an art form. It's super respectable in my eyes, and it's done as a passion project. But the fake Geometry Dash websites quickly took notice, and this was a goldmine to them. Now they could clickbait hundreds of real GD levels, serve up the Scratch versions, which they stole, and profit from all the ads around it. They also have these really funny AI-generated descriptions, like, in Geometry Dash I Spy with my little eye, you will overcome countless challenging challenges. Fly like a lightning-fast rocket past the spikes and obstacles ahead. Of course, they also sprinkle in some other random games or weird GD clones, but that's to be expected. The most notable of these websites is geometrydash.io, which has hundreds, maybe even thousands of these stolen Scratch projects. But really, there's tons of these websites. The more you look, the more you'll find. And it's not just Geometry Dash. You'll also find these for FNAF, Happy Wheels, Wordle, Slope, Backrooms, and so on. And even though these websites sometimes give you what you want, they are there specifically to trick you. They all run on the same code, so to spot one, just look for a footer that looks like this, or a comment section kinda like this. So that's where my last video ended, but lots has happened since then. For example, if you search Geometry Dash on Google, it says that some results have been removed due to a copyright complaint from the one and only RobTop Games. Turns out, he's been sending multiple of these and they actually work. The search results are improving and some bad websites don't even appear anymore. But it's pretty obvious that if you strike down one of these websites, two more will grow back. And for some reason, geometry-dash.io never dies. Probably because they keep changing their homepage to a different link. Speaking of that website, did you know that there's actually a kids.geometry-dash.io? I could not tell you why this exists, but it seems to have less ads, so maybe it's a legal thing. Also, a few days after I posted my video, GD.io added a disclaimer to their website, a non-official fan-made version of Geometry Dash. Then, this September, they added, "We are not the official game," in capital letters. They also credited the creator of the Scratch project. But if you go to the website now, you'll notice two things. Firstly, that disclaimer has been banished to a link all the way at the bottom of the page. And secondly, they're not running the Scratch version anymore. You see, as impressive as it is, Scratch Geometry Dash obviously doesn't play that well, and it's just a stolen project made by someone else. What these websites needed was a game that actually looked and played exactly like real Geometry Dash,
a recreation of the game so impressive that you could barely tell it apart from the real thing, and above all else, a game that they could have full control over the development of. This video isn't about the existence of these fake Geometry Dash websites or the scratch games that they steal, nor is it about all those other weird ripoffs that they also host. This video is about one single Geometry Dash clone that I've spent months of my life investigating, a game with the ambitious goal of becoming a perfect copy of Geometry Dash. A game that would undergo dozens of strange updates and break out into multiple spin-off games. A game that would build their own RobTop levels, and a game that would steal levels that never existed to begin with. But most importantly, a game that would absolutely break me as a human being. This is the story of Geometry Light. So, as much as I would love to jump right into the lore of this game, there's a few other GD copies I need to quickly highlight for context, and the first one actually shows up in my last fake GD video at 6 minutes and 25 seconds. There's Geometry Dash Unblocked, which is your more traditional Geometry Dash copy and not something made on Scratch. The levels are actually recreations of the Geometry Dash ones, like Associations is actually Clubstep with the monsters and everything. This is GeoJump, a pretty terrible copy of Geometry Dash that's been around for years. Despite the weird level names like Preamble, Let's Go, Gravitational, they're just really sad recreations of the main GD levels. However, Stereo Madness was replaced with some weird knockoff version fresh out of the recent tab. The game goes all the way up to Electrodynamics, or Planet Hunt, but as you can see, it looks and plays terribly. But what I want you to focus on is the music. It turns out that this game exclusively uses old tracks by F777, who you might know is the creator of Deadlocked, Sonic Blaster, and many other bangers. I asked him if he knew about this, and sure enough, they just grabbed these songs without permission. Funny enough, this game actually has a second version. It has a proper menu and uses the actual Geometry Dash songs, but they obviously don't sync. There's also a bunch of funky icons to pick from, as well as a shuffle button, which I made, by the way, for my Icon Kit website. Then that game got a second version, adding all the levels up to Finger Dash. And this time they don't have weird names, but that doesn't stop them from being awful. Then they made GeoJump World, which is the 10 GD World levels, followed by the challenge as an 11th. Once again, not good. I would even argue that the Scratch games play better than this. I thought it ended there, but then someone on Twitter sent me Slope Ball, a game about a heroic ball exploring several mysterious islands. It's just the exact same game rotated 10 degrees! Aside from making you a ball, they also cleaned up the menu and improved the physics a bit, but there's still nothing going for this game. The other game I need to quickly cover is what I call GD Unity, because it's a really faithful recreation of Geometry Dash made in the Unity game engine. I went over this game in GD Copy 7, so I'll keep it brief. Although this game looks really impressive, it has its flaws. They tried to recreate all the menus, but the buttons do nothing and there's typos everywhere. My favorites are Progress Bar and Quiche Checkpoint Mode. You can choose any icon from Geometry Dash, but death effects don't work and you're always forced to use the fire trail. The achievements menu is weird, and as it turns out, all the textures there come from me, from the old achievement page on my website GD Browser. Finally, and most importantly, the music doesn't sync and the physics suck. The ship gravity is brutal, the cube can bonk its head, the UFO is... what? And it gets significantly worse. Much like GeoJump, this game goes up to Electrodynamics, but all signs point to it being a completely different project by a different developer entirely. I actually got a hold of the developer at one point, but he didn't provide much useful information, and now he's completely ghosting me. You can't deny that this game lays a pretty good foundation, so it ended up branching out into a lot of spin-offs, like Meltdown, which turned out decent, but obviously has its flaws. Sub-Zero only has Press Start, and it's actually some weird extended version of the level. The ending is weirdly difficult. And it uses Geometrical Dominator! You had one job! There's also a Bloodbath spin-off for some reason, but this transition is impossible because every portal resets you to normal gravity. But I data mined the game, and yes, it is the entire level. It's faithful, but there's definitely some mistakes, like using the X object here, leaving out some creator logos, and filling in all the blank spaces with this object for some reason. Geometry Dash Scratch is probably the weirdest of the bunch, because it's the exact same as Meltdown, but they just changed the logo. I really could not explain the logic behind this one. Finally, they did Geometry Dash Breeze, which is actually a fan game by the creator Andrexel. He makes really good RobTop-styled levels, and you can play them all from his account. My favorite is Into the Zone, it plays so nicely. But yeah, for some reason they made the first three levels of Breeze. I don't know if that's an honor or kind of concerning. Once again, it's not great, and the spider is pretty silly. This game will show up again later, but for now, we can finally head back to geometry-dash.io, which is where this story really begins. And let me just explain how this video is gonna work. First, we're gonna go over the history of this website, everything they've done since my last video, as well as all the details of that Geometry Light game I keep hinting about. Then, we'll get into how the website starts to take a weird turn, and finally, I'm gonna completely tear it apart with data mining, clue gathering, and everything in between. This is something I've been investigating like a maniac for months, so strap in! Starting off, shortly after my last fake GD video, I realized that I should probably keep a closer eye on this website. So I set up a bot that posts to Twitter every time they add a new Scratch game to their lineup. When that video came out, in November of 2022, it seems like they were in the middle of a 9 circles phase, adding levels like Downbase, Crimson Clutter, Astronaut 13, just to name a few. In December, they claimed to add Sub-Zero, but it was just this random game. Then they changed it to the Scratch one a few days later. Following that, they would go on to add Scratch versions of Dryout all the way up to Finger Dash, even linking these games right from their homepage. Then they began working their way up the Gauntlet levels, with this masterpiece making its way onto the site on March 16th, 2023. June 30, we saw I Spy, July 18th we got Limbo, and then Change of Scene on the 21st. On August 5th, there was a lot of Skibbity Toilet and Among Dash. September added Mario Dash, which was, this. We also got Egg Dash and Spooky Dash, which are popular Scratch projects by Chipmunk with completely original levels and a new engine that runs much better than the other Scratch Geometry Dash. The site also started moving all their Scratch games to Turbo Warp, which is just a faster Scratch. In January of this year, they added Mario 64. It's literally just Mario 64, I'm not even joking. I have no idea how they got away with this. Someone on Twitter even beat it. They also added Lobotomy Dash, which is...
Fire in the heart!
Gotta love the default Unity physics. Turns out this one's hosted on lobotomy-dash.com, which is yet another fake Geometry Dash website where this is the front page game. It has a corner where you can watch Lobotomy Dash videos, and a long AI-generated description stating that a lobotomy is the process of curing mental illness by causing brain damage. It sounds absurd, but its effectiveness will surprise you. Finally, this April they added Dash Spider. The funniest part about this one is that they literally forgot to add a game. It's just a blank screen, there's no data. To this day, they're still adding more Scratch games and the occasional other slop you'd come to expect. Oh, and how could I forget? Back on the 8th of August, just before the 10-year anniversary of Geometry Dash, there was this random other game they added with the name Geometry Dash Lite. Normally, this isn't a very big deal, but this time, Scratch Geometry Dash vanished from the homepage of the site, and this game took its place. Right away, let's clear up that this is not the Unity version of Geometry Dash I showed earlier. It is made in Unity, but to keep things simple, we'll call this one Geometry Dash Unity, and this one Geometry Lite, which is also the display name for Real GD Lite on Apple devices. Just from looking at the menu, it's clear that this game is in a pretty unfinished state. Most of the menu options are labeled as coming soon, including Newgrounds, the only settings are for volume, and you can't choose a custom icon, despite the fact that they're literally flying by on the menu. The info box in the corner states that this is version 1.0, and the developer is geometrylite.io, which the More Games button also takes you to. It's yet another one of those fake GD sites, but back when this was released, this was the only game available on it. Once you press play, following a painfully slow transition, you're met with every level up until Jumper. Give one of them a try, and... yeah, so... this is the most perfect recreation of Geometry Dash that I've ever seen. It looks almost identical to the real thing, and the physics are more accurate than any other clone I've ever played. Even the ship controls surprisingly nicely. My only real nitpick is that, like with most copies, there's zero orb buffering. Also, the levels are literally one-to-one. Every tiny detail is placed correctly, and I have a suspicion that these were somehow ported over directly from the real game, which is definitely possible because I've done it many times. Now, is this game perfect? No, obviously not. The menu transitions take forever, respawning in practice resets your velocity, the pulsing rods sometimes have hearts, dryout is one word, and overall things just still feel kind of off. But whoever made this game still cooked really hard, and I respect them for it. I just wish it wasn't made solely as a cash grab for scam websites. But this is only version 1.0, so what's this game gonna do next? Well, 1 week later, they released version 0.38. Yes, it went backwards. As far as I can tell, the only difference in this version is that Jumper is now rated Demon, but everything else is the same. Over the next few months, they continued to update the game, even leaving a changelog on geometry-.io. Safe to say, this was their game, which unlike Scratch, they had full control over. The most notable additions were Time Machine through X-Step being added, and them dropping 2.2 months before RobDop did. I'm not really sure what fixed practice mode color change means, but by this version, the checkpoints were now blue instead of green. Not to mention, the progress bar setting was now progress bar, and auto checkpoints capitalized the letter P. As far as the main menu went, everything was still coming soon. But aside from that, they were still making steady progress. Jumper's difficulty was corrected, Dryout got its space back, the menu fading was cut entirely, the heart rods were gone, sadly, the icon and ship were changed to this, the ball controlled fine, but definitely felt more weird than the others, and the new levels were correct. On the flip side, orb buffering was still absent, and they didn't even try with the mirror portal. So at this point you might be thinking, is this really that impressive? These are pretty easy levels to remake, you can literally fit every object and trigger in this single screenshot. This is just Geometry-1.3, but there's coins, and you can't even pick an icon. And yeah, that's a pretty good point. It's cool, but not mind-blowing. What are they gonna do next? Add Clutterfunk? Oh. Well, I guess it's not that hard to make. Oh! Yeah, so just a few days later, they dropped World and Sub-Zero on the exact same day, November 27th, 2023. To no one's surprise, Geometry World just copies the exact same menu and engine as Geometry Light, and disappointingly, it's only the first three levels of the game. You know, the ones that don't have any move triggers. But they did get color channels working, as well as the animated objects, so props to them. 1 month later, just after Christmas, they would go on to add level 4, Years. And yeah, they got stuff moving, it was bound to happen eventually. Geometry Sub-Zero, on the other hand, was a lot more interesting, because when this game came out, there was no menu, pausing, or even practice mode. It just thrusts you right into press start and there's no way to leave. You're also now rocking the default icon set, except for the ball, which is this for some reason. And we get our first look at the robot. Spoilers, it doesn't control that great. But who am I to talk when they literally made press start? The effects, camera triggers, reversing, and everything in between. Though it is the old version from before the coins were reworked, and unlike Geometry Light, it was definitely made by hand rather than being ripped from the actual game. 1 month later, after the GD World update, they got around to adding a proper menu for the game, but it was very apparent that this was a brand new menu made from the ground up. The buttons are in slightly different places, and the only icons in the background are the default ones, except once again, the ball. Over in the pause menu, they fixed the progress bar typo, and despite what the button says, checkpoints were green again. For some reason, the level was called Press Start Full, even though it's just the normal version. But you can't really argue with 34 million views. Unlike Light and World, there's also a coming soon screen. Oh, and did I mention they added Knock'em? Not really much to say here, it's Knock'em. This level gives us our first look at the wave, and it does not control well. Which is weird, because how do you mess up the wave? We also get to try out the spider, which works, but looks kinda stupid. And on the main menu, it jumps for some reason. By the way, you know how Knock'em used to have really terrible coins? Well, somehow they made them even worse. The first coin is missing its little sparkle, so there's even less indication of it. The second coin's key is missing, so you just get it for free. And the last coin just doesn't exist. Finally, another month later, in late January, they added Power Trip. Once again, it's exactly what you'd expect, but they removed the smiley face in the wave part. And not only is this message not randomized anymore, but it just turns green on its own. Normally you have to click for that. Also, the second message does it too. To nobody's surprise, you get the last coin for free. They actually patched the spider exploit in this level, which technically puts them one step ahead of RobTop, but it's also iconic to the level at this point. Same goes for the robot. Also in January, they finally got around to releasing Meltdown, but they kind of phoned it in seeing that it's just one level, and they never added more. They also forgot the key at the start, but luckily they pushed an emergency update 1 day later that re-adds it. so it would be rude to say that they didn't care. Otherwise, this is just seven C's with nothing interesting about it. They went back to using the menu and icons from Geometry Light, so I'm not really sure why Sub-Zero didn't. And there you have it, the complete Geometry Light series. They never got around to updating the base game past X step, and basic features like the icon kit never happened either. So now that I've more or less set the scene, this is where the story actually begins. Remember how I said that there was another Scratch Geometry Dash game that wasn't a remix of the one by Griffpatch? This one, Spooky Dash by Chipmunk. It came out on October 27th, 2023, and it showed up on geometrydash.io 3 days later in time for Halloween. It's actually a really impressive game. It only has one level, Spooky Scary Skeletons, but it's completely original and the gameplay is great. It feels very RobTop styled, but like 1.0 RobTop styled. Nobody really makes this kind of gameplay anymore, so playing a level like this was a really great experience. On top of that, this game comes with an icon kit, and even a whole level editor which has formed a very passionate community. I'll leave a link to the Scratch project in the description in case you want to try it for yourself. Again, the level is unironically great. And the reason I bring this up is because a little while later, in the middle of December, my bot notified me that they stole the game a second time, but this time, under the name Geometry Spooky Dash instead of just Spooky Dash. So then, what happened to the first one? Okay, it's a different game, I guess, but what did they change it to? No. No, they didn't. I refuse to believe it. They made a copy of a Geometry Dash game that never even existed to begin with. Here's a side-by-side comparison, and as you can see, it's basically the same level. This is the only one in the game, and like I said before, it is in fact a really good level. Even the coin placements are really nicely thought out, which is rare to see nowadays. It's also cool to see a 1.0 styled level mixed with some extra decorations like cobwebs and fences. But the reason this is so crazy to me is that this level, Scary Skeletons, or just Spooky in the version they stole, has never existed, in real Geometry Dash at least. It was made by Chipmunk, in Scratch, for Scratch. I searched all over Geometry Dash for this level, but it simply isn't there. Yet, they stole it anyways. These guys have no chill. But it's not just the level they stole. Yes, it's running on the same Geometry Light physics as all the other games, but they redid all of the menus to match the Scratch project, even going as far as to use the same sound effects. They even copied the Choose Your Spook screen, making this the first Geometry Light game where you can choose an icon. And I'm sure you won't be surprised to hear that there's no credit anywhere in this game. It's blatant thievery. Aside from the obvious, I think one of the funniest parts of their Spooky Dash copy is that it came out in December. So if this was supposed to be a Halloween game, they completely missed the bus. But you know what they were just in time for? Yup, they made a Christmas Dash. Just like the last game, it has a Scratch-themed menu and only one level. It's also 1.0 styled with a few festive decorations, and again, it plays pretty nicely. However, unlike last time, the music is just a generic Christmas stock song and there's no sync at all. But hold on, there's no Christmas Dash on Scratch. So who are they stealing from? Yes! It turns out, and I'm not making this up, they just took a bunch of parts from Spooky Dash and rearranged the order they appear in. Don't get me wrong, this is a different level, but it's made with individual parts of Scary Skeletons. And if you think that's weird, then they sprinkle in some Poltergeist followed by the ship part in Back on Track. They put so much effort into making this level unoriginal, it's almost impressive. The final product is this weird, unholy fusion of levels with zero sync. The first coin is given for free, the second one comes from Spooky Dash, and the third one is Back on Track. Nothing about this makes sense, and that's exactly why I was so fascinated by it. But the laziness doesn't end there. Remember all the decorations from Spooky Dash, like these fences? All they did was retexture them a little bit. The floating candles are now various things, the grass is now Christmas trees, and the cobwebs are now... snow cobwebs. Yeah, they didn't even try. Also, the icons you can choose are mostly Santa heads, but more importantly, what the f*** is a Zass? Final verdict, this game is a disaster, and yet I kind of love it for that. Whoever made Geometry Light cares so much about making the game as accurate as possible to real Geometry Dash, but also cares so little about everything else. And that's basically the bootleg game industry in a nutshell. Great, so this brings us up to 6 Geometry Light games, all running the same code and released in the span of about 5 months. People are playing them, the comments from children are rolling in, and things are going great. So what's their next move? Surely it's something predictable and easy that won't make me lose my mind and lead to this video being way longer than it has any reason to- No. Please. So yeah, they also made Geometry Dash Breeze. I played it and it was close, but not great. But something felt off. The physics were different. So I quit back to the menu and that's when I realized, wait, this isn't Geometry Light. This is that other Unity remake from before, with the icon kit and the progress bar. So then why the hell is there now a message crediting Geometry Light for this? I thought they were like a competitor or something. So immediately, I came up with two theories. Number one, they're made by the same developer. But this makes no sense because there's nothing reused between them. The only real crossover is this message they added. But even that only appears on this version of the game. The original Breeze website doesn't have it. Not to mention, this version of Breeze was being developed while Geometry Light was. I asked the supposed developer if he made both games, but again, no replies anymore. He's probably onto me. Theory number two, the two of them joined forces. Alongside Breeze, they also launched a credited version of the original game that goes all the way up to Electrodynamics. But again, even though this version with the info box exists, it's not used on all the websites that this game was originally made for. Regardless, maybe the Geometry Light people didn't want to build all these extra levels, so they just bought the game off them. But it's just these two, there's no watermarked version of Meltdown or Bloodbath. Okay, so 8 Geometry Light games, two of which are technically not theirs. Now is probably a good time to address the credited website, geometrylight.io, because if we head over there, you can see that not only are these games listed there, but they're also the only games listed there. Unlike every fake GD website with random other stuff like Scratch Games and Skibbity Toilet, this one exclusively holds the games that they've been making. Strangely enough, XMustache is credited to Free Games Online, which was just a random other game website, but now it redirects to this one called One Games. Surely this won't show up again later, right? Ugh, alright, before we continue, let's just take a quick breather. I know this has been a lot of useless information, but hopefully you're doing okay so far. If you need some time to pause and take a break, let it all sink in, now would be a good time to do so. And while you're at it, maybe consider subscribing if you've found this interesting so far. I don't upload that often, and when I do, it's usually more crazy stuff like this, so at the very least keep it in the back of your head. At this point, you're fully up to date with the Geometry Light family up until January of 2024. All these games are chilling on geometry-.io, raking in views, and the main one is still front and center on the website. There's a disclaimer that it's a fan-made game, and all that fun stuff. And while I wish it was that simple, this is the part where I reveal that I've been keeping a secret. Because back in early November, like before they made Geometry World or Sub-Zero, my bot notified me of a new game called Geometry Light. And this was really weird, because there already was a Geometry Light, and it was still on the homepage like usual. So what was this one? Wait, what? It's the exact same thing, just with some kind of texture pack. But the original game was doing fine, it's not like they got copyright struck or anything. It's almost like this was a backup. As you can see, in this version, everything looks stupid. The levels are still unchanged, but many objects like portals, orbs, chains, and pulsing decorations are completely different. And while the default icon is the same, the ship and ball are now kind of goofy. They even tweaked the pause menu and changed the practice mode checkpoints to little ice cream shapes. But perhaps craziest of all, X-Step went from being rated insane to... Yeah, the difficulty faces in this version are crazy. We got Weird Spiral Chick, some sort of alligator, Maurice, Squiggly, and Kill It With Fire! On top of all that, there's still no icon kit for the game despite the real GD icons flying in the background. But there's definitely some problems, like sometimes the ship is invisible, and the layering is totally messed up. So this game sort of just chilled in the depths of geometry-.io for a couple of months. It was totally overshadowed by actual Geometry Light, and most people didn't even realize it existed at all. But as usual, something was cooking behind the scenes. In early February, they launched Geometry-Old Version, a game to blast back to, where rhythm-based game nostalgia collides with fresh challenges. Unsure what to expect, I checked it out and... No, please don't do this to me. So remember that really awful GD clone I showed at the start of the video? This menu song is the same one as that game's, Bring Me Back Piano Version by F777 in the same terribly low quality. Please ignore the fact that this has been my menu loop for months. I told you, this game has been eating away at my sanity. And what about the practice mode song? That would be Triple Fuse by F777, also super low quality, and the track used for the level Circulation in that other game. So what else is going on with this old version of the game? For starters, you might notice that all the disabled buttons were removed from the menu. Now it's just the volume settings, the play button, and a link to geometrylight.io. Heading over to the main levels, you'll see that...
Oh. Oh! Yep, they all have different names now, from Poltergeist being gravitational to Can't Let Go being Never Give Up. Most of the level names are close, but they're definitely not what the songs are actually called. And if any of these names sound familiar, that's because most of them are lifted, again, from that other game. In fact, out of the 10 levels available, 6 use the exact same name. This all led me to believe that these two games are in fact connected. In fact, even the icon was the same. It was a pretty strange conclusion to jump to at the time, but trust me, I would end up finding even more evidence. So this begs the question, what's the deal with that older game then? Why are they remaking Geometry Dash for the second time? Well, I believe that one was a prototype, testing out if they could get the basic physics working, and more importantly, if people would actually play the game, and once it took off, that's when they started work on Geometry Lite. In the moment, this was like information overload, so I decided to relax and just play the game. Here, let's try Dryout, or Drought. Guys? I don't think this is Dryout. That's right, it turns out that all 10 levels had different names, songs, and most importantly, level design. Some of the levels have similar gameplay, but they're very clearly not the ones that RobTop made. At least partially, because each level only has different gameplay for the first 20% or so. After that, it's back to normal, like nothing ever happened. I don't know about you, but I find this fascinating. Not only did they attempt to make their own gameplay, but they tried to mimic the styles of iconic levels that already exist. And if you don't find that interesting, maybe skip ahead, because we're going over every level. Starting off with Stereo Dash, which uses a remix of Stereo Madness by El Midi, formerly Melon. Surprisingly, this game actually credits all the music they used except for F777, but it seems like Stereo Madness got credited to Hexagonist instead, even though that's a totally different remix. I highly doubt they asked for permission to use these songs, realistically they probably just searched Newgrounds for good replacements. The level opens right away with a double spike, and it seems to get into some more technical moves much quicker than actual Stereo Madness, but overall it still flows exactly like the original level, so I don't think it's all that bad. After this weird transition into the ship portal, the level changes back to normal. Let's Go is one of the better edits they did, but I'm probably just saying that because this remix by Supersoniker is absolutely fantastic. Like dude, this goes so hard, well done. I think the most notable gameplay changes are this weirder introduction to the yellow pad and the addition of a triple spike here. There's a little branching path shortly after, but neither route has a benefit over the other. Back on Track has never had particularly memorable gameplay, so it's hard to tell what actually changed. But the cutoff is right about here, just before the first coin. Speaking of coins, where did the third one go? Did they add an extra coin to the beginning of the level? They added an extra coin to the beginning of the level, and I think I'm gonna give it a C because it's actually pretty clever, but I think most people would stumble into it by accident. It also should have replaced the first coin and not the third. But that's right, the coin tier list never dies. Moving on to Gravitational, rocking Fendraka's remix of Poltergeist. This one starts with full spikes instead of half, and even has some magenta orb action, which definitely isn't off-putting. Other than that, there really isn't much to say about this level, and it changes back to normal pretty quickly. Drought uses an arrangement of Dryout by Vision, made in Magic Piano of all things. Like you saw before, it opens with a clubstep monster with red orbs for eyes, something that wasn't added until 2.1. This one has some pretty weird gameplay decisions, like this part where you drop down onto the spikes. Out of all the levels they changed, this is actually the least edited one, switching back to the regularly scheduled RobTop gameplay at just 16%. Step After Step opens up looking like a recent tab level, but that's because I keep forgetting it's the actual background color for Base After Base. This remix is by iMoxta, and it's really cool, but doesn't keep sync with the actual song. I'm a little sad to say that the missing spike got overridden with new gameplay, but fortunately the boring first coin did as well. And they replaced it with one that's literally impossible to get. I don't even know how to rank this one. The level goes back to normal at 30% just before the drop, but the edited gameplay before it is very heavily referenced from the original. Never Give Up uses Cool as Pie's remix of Can't Let Go, and this one just feels like something you'd find in a map pack. It's really not that interesting. The gameplay feels robbed of anything that once made it unique, so now it's just a 1.0 level. You have to fall a little earlier to get the coin, and that coin is also the exact cutoff between old and new gameplay. Step Jump's remix is brought to you by Demonic Nobility, and this one hurts me because look at how it begins. What did you do to Jumper? It had one of the most iconic beginnings!
Overall, there's just less of those thin pillars that were a staple of the level. This one has a pretty easy coin where you just go up instead of down, and after that, the level's back to normal. The coin replaces the one in the first ship, which is a bit of a bummer, and you can even see the small spikes from where it used to be. But I'm gonna give it a D tier instead of an F, just because everything after the coin is RobTop gameplay, so this spike wall you land on is actually repurposed from the original level. Teleporter uses a GarageBand cover of Time Machine by It's Dubstep, but they compressed it just a little bit. So it sounds like this. They also credited this song to Leo BSK, who did make a song called Time Machine, but it's totally different. Anyways, this level actually does a good job keeping the spirit of Time Machine, but for some reason you like rise into the air. After that, it's pretty generic, and these four orbs mark the beginning of RobTop's part. If you fall here, there's a clearly edited version of the first coin structure, which you'd normally be on top of. I like how you can barely see the coin, but it's still too easy to get, so it gets another D tier. Cycle Step uses an interesting remix by Sinfang, who they credited as Yinfang. It does kind of feel like Cycles, but once again, a lot of its charm has been lost. If you fall over here, you land in some remnants of the old level, but it doesn't lead anywhere. They kept the little orb chamber, which is nice, but now it's floating in the sky, and after that, the level quickly returns to normal. Finally, X Adventures uses a remix by Serial, and for the most of it, this one feels the exact same, just with a less unique first cube. The ball is kind of funny though, because... you had one job! Yeah, they left out a portal, making this part impossible, but it is normal after that. And there you have it, Geometry Light Old Version. Why does this exist? It makes me feel violently uncomfortable, so thanks for that. It's a good thing I can still play normal Geometry Light on the homepage, right? Uh-oh. You see, when they released the old version, the old was referring to the fact that this is Geometry Light now. So really, they were doing us a favor by releasing this version, because I do not want to stare at... that. Now, if you were paying really close attention, you might have noticed that this version of the game has a different menu compared to the one I showed earlier. And that's because this one has the new levels too, complete with their names and music. Interestingly enough, this one fixed a bunch of gameplay issues from old version, even though they were released at the same time. X-Step had its missing portal re-added, albeit upside down, the extra gameplay underneath Cycles was cleared out, and another orb was added to base after base so you could get the first coin. And now I can properly say that it sucks, F tier. Alongside these changes, GD.io itself also went through a few tweaks at the time. For example, they changed their logo from this to this. In the corner of the site, they added a big box linking to GD old version. They changed the tab name from Geometry Dash to Geometry Light Dash the Rhythm. The game description was updated, which they do a lot. And finally, the disclaimer directly under the game was removed. It's almost like they were becoming increasingly paranoid about copyright or something. It's almost like GeometryDash.io got taken off of Google search due to a DMCA takedown from RobTop, one that was issued just a few days before they made all of these changes. But they got around the takedown by changing the homepage's link to geometry-.io/light. It really should not be that easy, but apparently it is. Still, it was alarmingly clear that this website was now in panic mode. So much that they even paused adding new scratch games for a little, when it was usually one every day or two. They cooked way too hard with Geometry Light, and now we're stuck with... ugh. So after that, they were chilling for a little while. Unsurprisingly, the game also updated on GeometryLight.io because that's where the games are actually being hosted. Also, all the spin-offs like Meltdown, Sub-Zero, Spooky, and so on were completely unchanged. Eventually, about a month passed since this weird reskin was deployed, and that's when they made their next move, with a new game replacing this one, called Geometry Light. Yup, they did it again. To their credit, this is a much better reskin than the previous one. The textures are a lot more polished, and it looks a lot more Geometry Dash-like, which maybe they were trying to avoid at first. The levels themselves are the same edited versions of Stereo Dash through X Adventures, and thankfully, the difficulty faces actually make sense now. I'll never forget you, Maurice. But what's new to this reskin is the fact that they changed a lot more of the in-game textures. The most obvious difference is probably the background and ground, but look closer and you'll see that all the blocks are just slightly different now. The default block uses a much uglier gray gradient that stays visible even when the background is black, and the other blocks just look kind of blurry. Also, your icon is this guy now. He's basically the face of Geometry Light as far as I'm concerned. You've also got this cool airplane ship and a pretty straightforward ball. As usual, you can't change your icon, and the ones behind the menu have just been taken out entirely. Interestingly enough, they also updated Sub-Zero to use this reskin, but every other spin-off was untouched. And even still, the unskinned version of Sub-Zero is still available on some websites, meaning they're still hosting both. In order for both versions to coexist, they have to be hosting both of them, but more on that later. There's really nothing interesting to share about Sub-Zero, all the levels and songs are unmodified, so really it's just new textures. We've got a few new goofy backgrounds for the levels, as well as a brand new icon set. Here's the cube, the ship, ball, robot, wave, and the spider. Finally, in late April, they updated Geometry Dash old version, or rather downgraded it back to the original Geometry Lite. The original textures, songs, and levels. It really reminds me of a simpler time, when the Geometry Lite lore looked like this, and not this. But that is where Geometry Lite stands today. No more tricks, I promise. As of writing this video, if you check out Geometry Lite, these are the games that you will see. Just go in with an ad blocker, because I still don't think they deserve to profit off this. But of course, you should know by now that that's not the end of the story. Because on April 1st, 2024, they hit us with one final blow. Remember how I said that there was another Scratch Geometry Dash game that wasn't a remix of the one by Griffpatch? This one, Egg Dash by Chipmunk. It's basically just Geometry Dash, but you're an egg. This game came out 4 months before the original Spooky Dash did, and Spooky Dash is technically a reskin of this one. But the levels are completely different, and this time there's three of them. Once again, they're all 1.0 styled and actually really good. Like with Spooky, this game was sitting on GeometryDash.io for a long time, and it seems like at some point, whoever made Geometry Lite realized that it's a prime target to steal from, likely because it's not a real Geometry Dash game, so there wouldn't be any copyright issues. It also perfectly lined up with Easter, which continued the trend of them stealing Scratch projects for certain holidays. And that brings us to their version of Egg Dash, which you'll immediately notice uses the exact same reskin as Geometry Lite, unlike the Scratch-themed one that was made for Spooky and Xmas Dash. But similar to those games, it only had one level, Shell Shock, which was also the name of the real Egg Dash's first level. Now, here's what the level looks like in the original game. And here's what their stolen version looks like. Wait, this is not the same level! The gameplay is completely different, the song is Heartbeat by Coldbreaks, credited by the way, and there's little decorations like flowers, these flags, and even... Yeah, you can't make this up. They used Easter Island heads as a decoration for their Easter game. And honestly, I respect it. But what shocked me the most is how good this level is. This is some of the most fun 1.0 styled gameplay I've played in a long time, and it even makes me a little sad to think that you never see levels like this in actual Geometry Dash anymore. The gameplay doesn't exactly do anything memorable, but it's still really enjoyable in the moment. There's zero unfair jumps, and I'd put it at around the same difficulty as Back on Track. It also properly syncs, with background changes and jumps that really complement the music. If you're wondering about the coins, this game doesn't have any, because it has cupcakes. The first one is in a wall in the ship part and it kind of plays out like that one in Base After Base. The second one requires you to fly up in this ship section, and for the last one, you just need to hit this orb to reach an upper area that recovers with a pretty blind jump. They're all like D tiers, but they still have lots of charm. Oh, and one last thing. This is an XL level spanning the entire song, which is 2 minutes and 40 seconds. There aren't any major choke points aside from this unnerved triple spike about halfway in, but still, to make things less frustrating, they added an interesting new checkpoint system. Throughout the level, there's a ton of invisible checkpoints, and when you die, you can watch an ad to respawn at one. And yes, using these still counts as a legitimate completion. But is it really legitimate in your heart? So when I saw this level for the first time, there was one huge thought on my mind. This is a fantastic level! Who did they steal it from? It is way too good of a level to come from the same people who gave us Xmas Dash, so I looked everywhere, Geometry Dash, Scratch, but this level, a 3-minute 1.0 RobTop styled layout of Heartbeat, simply did not exist. They made it. And that right there was my breaking point. It was exactly when I realized that I wanted to investigate every last secret Geometry Lite was holding. Who are these people? How are they making these games, and why? But where would I even start? These are Unity games, it's not like I could just open up the game files. Unity encrypts all that stuff really well, and even better when it's a web game. There was really nothing I could do. Just kidding, here it is decompiled and open in the Unity editor. Obviously, I don't have access to any of the game's code, but I do have all the assets as well as the actual levels. And what shocked me more than anything is that these levels use actual Geometry Dash triggers. They've got color triggers with all the settings like copy color and blending. Also, for some reason, this ship part, and nowhere else in the game, uses pulse triggers. Why would they go through the effort of implementing that just for a tiny section of the level? The rest of the level has pulses, but they do it with background triggers. Maybe the level was made by multiple people? Also look, here's all the invisible checkpoints in the level. Overall, the whole Unity scene is laid out in a way that looks a lot like this was ported over from some other program. You could tell they definitely didn't build the level right from Unity, but there's no saying for sure if it was built in Geometry Dash, especially when you factor in these decorations. Anyways, my first order of business was to write some code that takes every object in this level and prints its texture and coordinates to a file. Then I took each texture and mapped it to an object in Geometry Dash. For example, this block is named 2Square01, and I mapped it to the default block, which is object ID 1. A little more coding later, and there you have it, a perfect port of Shellshock in real Geometry Dash. This isn't a recreation, this is one-to-one. I didn't place any of these blocks in the editor. It is worth noting that I replaced the Moai statues with pulsing rods, because how would I even go at making this in Geometry Dash? Anyways, here's the ID if you want to play it. It would be kind of funny if it got raided, but I'll leave that decision to some rogue mod. Also, what's great about having this code is that now I could do the exact same thing for Spooky Dash and Xmas Dash. I debated porting all of the modified RobTop levels, but it felt kind of boring compared to the fully original one, so I passed. At this point, I sort of just became mad with power, because then I started using this code to port over other games as well. If you know my Geometry Dash Copy series, you might remember this one game that kept showing up. Sometimes it's Mario themed, sometimes it's rabbit themed, but it's always the same four levels. This one was made in a different engine, and the level data was a lot more complicated than Unity, but after making a program to render the levels in my browser, I somehow got it working. Never underestimate the power of a hyper-fixated programmer. Anyways, you can play all these levels on the Rob's Basement account. I've been continuing to port levels from other ripoff games like Preamble from GeoJump, so feel free to check it out and look at the level descriptions for further context. Right now I'm pretty close to porting over that Bloodbath recreation, but I've been running into some weird issues, so it's on the back burner for now. So anyways, now that I had this game decompiled, I could finally dig deeper and uncover all the secrets that Geometry Light was holding. Let me just get the real Egg Dash open as a reference and... wait. Why is it called Egg Zone now? No, don't do this to me. Yeah, so a few weeks later, they added two more levels and renamed Shellshock to Egg Zone. And yes, the game did have a coming soon screen, but as a Geometry Dash player, I never thought I'd see the day where it wasn't a lie. The two new levels are called Yoki Joys and Howl Haven, and both claim to be easy one star, just like the first one. I also have no idea what those names are supposed to mean. Real Egg Dash used puns like Shellshock, Egg Static, and Cracked Up. What the hell is Howl Haven? And what's the deal with Yoki Joys? And why is Shellshock called Egg Zone now? So anyways, level 2 is also really solid, just like the first one. It's the exact same style of gameplay and decoration, but I'd put this one at around Jumper's difficulty since it introduces gravity changes for both the cube, or egg, and the ship. The song for this one is a remix of Pneumatic Tokyo by Envy, made by Hallett. The song isn't credited, but when Hallett found out about this, they were kind of honored to have their song used, which is a really respectable attitude to have, at least it's not stuck in a game like Xmas Dash. One of the more interesting things I noticed about this level is that the checkpoints are visible now, unlike in level 1, where they're still hidden even after the update. Like I said, the level plays really well, and I would even say that's a little more interesting than the first one. However, it's a lot shorter, clocking in at a minute 45, which is still longer than any RobTop level so far. The final quarter of the level has some really heavy impossible game slash base after base energy, and it's probably the weakest part in my opinion. But otherwise, it's good. At least, until we get the coins involved. First coin, fly through this pillar while upside down. It's like a fairer version of Jumper's coin. I'll take it. B minus, maybe? Second coin, literally impossible to miss. And the third coin, literally impossible to miss. They probably didn't know where to put these two coins, but at the very least, couldn't you have taken 30 seconds out of your day to at least pretend you tried? This is embarrassing. Level 3 immediately kicks off with a bunch of triple spikes, which gives it some pretty heavy Time Machine vibes. The song for this one is Distorted Sakura by Ectobot, which was heavily inspired by Shinto by Envy. I don't know why they have a sudden obsession for Envy remixes, but they go pretty hard, so who am I to complain? This level probably has the least to say about it. The gameplay is just harder, and many of the jumps are much more tight. It doesn't feel nearly as tested as the others, and has quite a few areas where early jumps or orb hits will unfairly kill you. This level's also about a minute 45, and for some reason it ends by suddenly switching to X-Step's visual style. And then it spells out Egg Pop with blocks, which I have no idea what that means. So yeah, I ported these levels over to Geometry Dash as well, and they play exactly the same, but I think the yellow orb physics are slightly different because there's this one orb in Howlhaven you have to delay a lot more. I decided to keep the checkpoints invisible, but they're in the editor if you really care. I highly doubt that these levels are stolen, but there's clearly a lot of RobTop influence, like Jumper in this part and Time Machine over here. My theory is that they were made by multiple people. This is the only spot in the game that uses pulse triggers. Level 2 uses two red pads at the start, then never again. Level 1 has a single gravity change that seems to stitch two parts together, and there's many spots where the style of the level takes a complete 180. There's probably more details I'm missing, but I'll leave it for someone else to look further into. Now here's the funny part. When I was porting over these levels, I found a fourth unused level called Cracked Up, and it was completely finished. And this was a crazy find, because the level is exactly the same as Yoki Joy's, just extended to span the entire 4-minute song. We're talking a full XXL Egg Dash level, and it is hard. Obviously the first half is exactly the same, but once you reach the new gameplay, it quickly jumps up to like map pack difficulty. It's still surprisingly sight readable, but pretty much every death past this point is going to be due to some kind of bug. Jump too early, you're screwed. Jump too late, you're screwed. Hit an orb wrong, you're mega screwed. It doesn't look that hard on video, but trust me, there's a lot of spots with really unforgiving timings. Case in point. Just a reminder that this level is 4 minutes long. I did eventually beat this level after like 20-90% deaths and many more rage quits, and I'd definitely say this is a demon, but like a long nerve control one. And if you don't believe me, here's the ID, go ahead and try it, or give it to someone you hate. When I realized that this was an extension of level 2, it made me wonder if that level had such lazy coins because it was after they cut it down. And sure enough, the two free coins were relocated, but they still weren't great. Coin 2 is basically free, and coin 3 is literally free, so clearly they've learned nothing. Anyways, if you want to see all 4 of the Egg Dash levels in their entirety, I've uploaded a showcase to my second channel, and the link will be in the description. Alright, welcome to the spicy part of the video, because now that you're familiar with all the Geometry Light games, it's time to look inside and see all the things they don't want you to see. And trust me, there was a lot. Let's start off with Egg Dash, where despite playing as an egg, the game has every single 2.1 icon in the game files. This actually applies to every Geometry Light game, but they only seem to get used for the menu. These are the only two icons actually used in Egg Dash, and there's another unused set to go along with it. The game has 9 different backgrounds, 4 of which are brand new, and the other 5 come right from GD. This is the only one that actually gets used. But weirdly enough, the backgrounds folder also contains an image called screenshot1.png, which looks like this. It's a cropped image of the actual GD editor, but it was taken in 2.1 based on the lack of the warp tool. And the reason I find it interesting is because this is from the level Viking Arena by RobTop, but all the monsters on this wall have been removed. You can see that I'm at the exact spot they took the screenshot. But above all else, it shows that they know how to open a RobTop level in the editor, even if it means just finding a copyable version. But if you look up Viking Arena copy in GD, virtually every single result is this fan-made recreation that's straight up wrong. And if most GD players don't notice that, I can guarantee that they wouldn't either. So either they somehow realized it was wrong and looked for an actual copy, or they just took it from the game files, but it takes some pretty deep knowledge to know how to port those into your saved levels. Either way, it's really suspicious. Heading over to the first version of regular Geometry Light, there's a few more screenshots lying around, like a really poorly photoshopped mock-up of their settings menu. There's also a shot of them getting 3% on Stereo Madness, and another of them beating it in practice mode after 85 attempts, and it makes me wonder if they're actually qualified to be remaking this game. Alongside those screenshots, we have the textures for every single object up to 2.1, and like icons, this is also the case with most Geometry Light games. This folder is an interesting one because all of the icon kit buttons here use the exact same file names as the ones on my online icon kit website. And while this could be a coincidence, the fact that they also grabbed the site's shuffle button says otherwise. Wait, does that make me part of the problem? But most damning of all is this folder called UI Sun Lam, with a whole lot of unique textures that just so happened to perfectly match that older Geometry Dash clone, which I called a prototype. So I think this pretty much confirms that they're connected. But what about the folder name? Well, Sun Lam seems to be a Vietnamese name. It's not enough info to track down a specific person, but it could hint at where these games are being made. Finally, and most importantly, the levels aren't just recreations of RobTop levels, they're direct rips. Every object and every trigger is in the exact same place, and this also extends over to Geometry World, including the move triggers, as well as Geometry Meltdown, though there's a couple of details missing. I kind of like how World's move trigger code had no easing, but Meltdown's did, because it showed that they implemented whatever they needed as they went on. The game files for the reskins are especially interesting to me because they have a lot of unreleased UI images. For example, that first reskin they made, we can see a new icon and background that never made the cut. We can also see what the stats menu would have looked like, and even the icon kit. Though these are most likely concept images and not screenshots from the actual game. Also, that shop sign isn't for decoration, there's a shop mock-up too, and I can only imagine what they were smoking when they approved this. Surely enough, the newer reskin has even more screenshots. Here we can see an unused version of the level select, which later became this. You'll also notice Stereo Madness has its normal name, and that they got 52% in practice move. They also cleaned up the shop design a little bit, and added a dollar store version of my icon. But there's actually two more unused icons in the files. One is this guy, and the other is... both terrifying and extremely based. On top of that, here's five backgrounds they made, and a collection of difficulty faces, the last of which never made the cut. Sadly, the previous reskin didn't even bother with one. Finally, we have Geometry Sub-Zero, where the levels were built in a completely different way. The triggers are squares now, and nothing matches up with real Geometry Dash at all. So it looks a lot like these ones were made by hand. Like the others, this game also had a few screenshots left in. And by a few, I mean 164. The vast majority of them are just low-quality YouTube screenshots, which they probably referenced when building the levels. For Press Start, they were watching every Geometry Dash level with coins, but switched over to Nexus's Sub-Zero video halfway through. Then for Knock'em, there's a single screenshot of Guitar Showcase, but not even 1% in, they switch to Nexus. There's no screenshots for Power Trip, but the randomized messages that appear in Nexus's video are the exact ones they used in their version of the level, and I'm sure it's not a coincidence. This leaves us with 7 remaining screenshots, which look like they're from the main game, but something is clearly off. The menu says Geometry Dash Full, and the corner holds 2 GitHub links. The level select says Stereo Madness Full, as well as Knock'em Full, and this screen has at least 30 levels. Attempts are called tries, and the checkpoints are blue again. At first I thought this was some ultimate Geometry Light game they were trying to make, but the real giveaway was this screenshot where the attempt count isn't perfectly centered. You see, you can easily change Geometry Dash's text by opening the EXE in a hex editor, or anything really, and just searching for the messages. But since these are bytes of a carefully compiled game, you can only change letters because adding or removing them would shift the wrong data into every address of the game. And here, it looks a lot like they changed the string attempt blank to try blank followed by 4 spaces, so it's the same length. You know, the spaces that would go right here. Long story short, this is clearly some crudely edited version of real Geometry Dash, but how could I get my hands on it? It was literally just sitting on GitHub and they definitely didn't make it. Yeah, so this is Geometry Dash Full, a weird edit of 2.1 that contains a full version of every main level. I'm not sure how they found this or why they even used it considering the Sub-Zero levels are just 2.1 recreations, but this might explain why their version of the game calls all the levels full. And yeah, you can see it's got the blue checkpoints and tries and everything. All of the edits in this game are hilarious. Like, the editor button is removed, but all they did was make the texture invisible. There's also a bonus level called Relax Level 2, which is just... nope. That about wraps up all the interesting stuff I found in the game files, but it turns out that the real juicy stuff was outside. Remember how I said that all these games are hosted on geometrylight.io and how other websites just hook up to it? That way, they automatically update and don't need to host it themselves. Well, believe it or not, these games aren't actually hosted on geometrylight.io. They're hosted on geometrylight.github.io. GitHub is a website where you can publish and manage code, and github.io allows you to host a little website. So all I did was go to Geometry Light's GitHub account, and lo and behold, a master repository of all their games. Unfortunately, they've already been compiled, so you can't see any code. They're basically just using this as a free host for their games. Now, I fully understand that by drawing attention to this repository, they're probably going to take it down shortly after this video releases, but really, it was a matter of time anyways. On the bright side, you know what's cool about GitHub? You can easily see a log of every change they've ever made, allowing me to monitor whenever they release a new version. And you know what's even cooler? You can view the full history and download every old or changed file. So what do you do when you have this massive collection of Geometry Light games with over 100 updates that you could just download? Obviously, you go through all of them, downloading every version of every game they've ever uploaded here. So if you're wondering how I was showing all those old versions over the course of this video, well, it's because I spent the afternoon making an archive of the 80 plus versions I could get my hands on. It's probably not something I'm going to release, mainly because it's super hacked together. If you're wondering why there's 5 versions of Light, they represent the different reskins as well as if they use the new levels or not. Weirdly enough, there were 6 updates for GeoJump, which was that older game, meaning that they were still maintaining it to some degree. But all they really did was rearrange the menu and add a more games button. Also, the other Unity versions like Breeze seem to rely on some extra code because the icon kit shows up like this, and the play button... yeah, that's not right. One last thing to note is that these games try really hard to prevent you from just downloading and playing them. That way, competitors can't steal and profit off them. If the game detects that you're on an unauthorized website, it immediately redirects you to Geometry Light. But I think they forgot that you can bypass this with one line of code, the one that makes the "Are you sure you want to leave this site" pop-up appear. Just press no and you're good. They did add a better security measure in newer versions, but we'll get to it later. So by now, I already had pages and pages of notes on Geometry Light. This game was consuming my life, and I would lie awake at night wondering where I could find more answers. And it felt like every time I tried to leave it behind, that's when I would find my next big clue. It was quite literally dragging me back. But surely it doesn't go deeper, right? Hey, so did you know that the loading screen for every Geometry Light game says onegames.io? In the actual game, it links to geometrylight.io, but that game exclusively holds Geometry Light stuff, and OneGames has a bit of everything. It's just your average free games website advertised as the best one with no interruptions or microtransactions, probably because the product is you. Also, if you remember from before, Xmas Dash's Free Games Online website also redirects to here. Speaking of Xmas Dash, when they added it to the GitHub, they also added a game called Santa Run, which is still in the repository. It's just a weird Christmas Subway Surfers ripoff that has nothing to do with Geometry Dash. And would you look at that, there it is on OneGames, right next to Blue Mushroom Cat Run, which is the same game reskinned to... I don't even want to say it. Overall, this is really weird, because Geometry-.io is connected to Geometry Light, but now Geometry Light is connected to OneGames. So are all these websites by the same people? I decided to check out the other games they offer, and fortunately they made it pretty easy to tell which ones are made by them and which ones are just random hosted games. For example, one game they made is Stick Run, and look at those moves! This is a completely original game concept that's never been seen before. Here's another game called Gorilla Adventure. In this game, you control a gorilla that has to get over... oh, I see where this is going. What about FNF Music 3D?
1, 2, 3...
Okay, that's enough research for today. As you'd probably expect, the rest of their games just continue this pattern of being garbage, but I did notice that a lot of them start with a play button like this, and it usually means it's hosted on a different website. And sure enough, inspecting the page shows that it's from html5gamedistribution.com, which is a huge collection of web games that they probably uploaded these to. A little bit of searching later, and I found all of their games under the name GM Media. Well, all the ones they uploaded here. Notably GeoJump, Egg Dash, Xmas Dash, and obviously Gorilla Adventure. I knew I was onto something because back when I loaded the games up in Unity, the company name was always set to GM Soft. So Geometry Light, OneGames, GM Media. Googling GM Media gives you nothing valuable, so I tried GM Media Geometry Dash and it led me to a LinkedIn page for Light Version Geometry Dash, who was a game developer at GM Media. This was huge, it meant that I found them! But little did I know, I just entered the labyrinth. The first thing I noticed about this profile is that the GM Media they listed was just some regular unrelated company. It also said that they were from Pennsylvania. And while they definitely had a Geometry Light banner, the profile photo was from the game Retro Bowl. The only other thing on the page was a link to another fake Geometry Dash website, as well as a Reddit and Twitch account. The website's homepage used to be Geometry Light, but as of right now it's been changed to the older game. Actually, quick update, it's the other Unity game now without the Geometry Light watermark. Aside from that, it's just another Geometry Dash site filled with stolen Scratch projects and other random stuff. So next I checked their Twitch. Their account was empty, but it did have a bio. Geometry Dash Light, where geometry meets rhythm. Feel the burn and meltdown, explore global beats and world, and brave icy hurdles in Sub-Zero. To my surprise, this one linked to even more websites, like Behance, which had the same bio, and 5 more websites. So naturally, I checked out their DeviantArt, which linked me to their Vimeo, which linked me to whatever issue is, which linked me to Twitter, and finally, we reached a dead end. But obviously, this branches out so much further. How much further, you ask? You're probably wondering, what kind of crazy person would map out every account they've made and where they link to? And to that I say, after everything you've seen in this video, do you really think I'm sane? In total, they've made accounts on about 70 websites, and it's very obviously for search engine manipulation, because if Google sees a bunch of people talking about this website, it will show up higher in search. Ironically, it doesn't even show up, so maybe it got banned or something. If you want to check out the full graph I made, the link is in the description. Question is, did Geometry Light make this link farm, or was it just by whoever made this website? Well, maybe the links themselves would have some answers. First off, pretty much every account was made on January 23rd or 24th of this year. Nothing particularly eventful happened then, other than Geometry Sub-Zero getting Power Trip a few days earlier, and the first reskin being released a week later. On chess.com, yes, they have a chess account, it shows that they're from Vietnam, but they chose some address in Pennsylvania that doesn't even exist. Meanwhile, Vimeo claims that they're from, I hope I pronounced this right, Houston, Hoa Kỳ, which is the Vietnamese word for USA. And freelancer.com straight up says they're from Vietnam, offering to work for $2 an hour. This all seems to suggest that, yeah, the whole Geometry Light operation comes from Vietnam. We also had that name in the game files, and the time zone even matches up with when they use GitHub. Also, if you're wondering about the Retro Bowl profile picture, that's because some of the accounts link to RetroBowlOnline.io, where you can play Retro Bowl online. This site also seems to have its own link farm, but I'm guessing they began switching some sites over to promote Geometry Dash instead. Speaking of that, you might have noticed that they often use the name Geometry Dash Light 68, and if you're wondering why they have the 68, well, it's because Geometry-.ee's link farm stole all the good names. So at this point, I felt kind of stuck. Yes, I found something funny, but it doesn't help with the Geometry Light mystery at all, and it also doesn't help that ever since Egg Dash, nothing new has happened. In late April, they updated all the games to have some advertising and security tweaks, but that was about it. GeometryLight.io has been untouched for months, and still doesn't even show Egg Dash, and Geometry-.io just went back to adding a couple of Scratch games every day. So, was Geometry Light dead? Were they moving on to Guerrilla Adventure or something? We still never got the Icon Kit, or Shop, or anything like that. Not even Clutterfunk, for that matter. This whole time, one of my biggest questions was how you actually make a fake Geometry Dash site. Because they all look the same, work the same, and even run the same code behind the scenes. And the same goes for all of the non-Geometry Dash websites as well. It's pretty obvious that they're all built off the same template, but then where do you find it? Maybe it's on some market on the dark web? Either way, I could find no info on this. It seemed like nobody on the internet has even asked this question before. So does that make me the crazy one? Am I the only one who's ever questioned this? Surely I could find at least part of an answer. With nothing left to dig into, I decided to check out those recent updates they launched. To the average player, the only difference was the version number. But really, they switched to a newer Unity version and even exported the games in a slightly different way. And above all else, now when you play them on an unauthorized website, it just deletes the entire page and replaces it with a link to Geometry Light. And the way they do it is super simple. Inside the game's code is a line that checks the website you're currently on, and it sends that info over to onegames.io. Once it's sent over, OneGames will send back some settings based on the website you're on. Conveniently, I'd already gathered a master list of all the fake Geometry Dash websites I've come across, so I decided to write a program that sends each URL to OneGames to see what it sends back, and if I could find any patterns. And let me tell you, I struck gold. What I learned is that every website can be in one of three states. The most common state is neutral. This means that you can embed the game, which means putting it in a little box which loads the game from geometrylight.io. But what you can't do is host it, as in download the files off GitHub, put them on your own site, and then load from there. Because if you do that, you could just stay on one version and never update. Neutral is the default for all websites, so the only time it won't work like that is when someone at OneGames manually changes it. The second state is verified, and it's most likely given to websites that OneGames either owns or just made a deal with. Verified websites are allowed to host games, though they usually embed from Geometry Lite anyways. They also probably get some special stuff related to ads, but I haven't really looked into it. This state interests me a lot because you can't really contact these scam game websites. All the emails are fake and anything you send is instantly trashed, so the only way to get verified is if you're in the underground business along with them. Some of the verified websites include OneGames, Geometry-.io, GeometryLite.io, Geometry Game, which appears really high on Google right now, Geometry Free, Geometry-World, and a few other websites that all use Geometry Lite games. On the opposite end, the third and final state is blocked. These are websites that cannot use their games under any circumstances, and my guess is that they give it to all their competitors who aren't worthy of Geometry Lite's power. However, I could only find 5 websites in this state. The first two are Geometry-PC and Geometry-3D. They're probably just competitors, so both of them took the L and have to go back to hosting the Scratch game. The third one is Geometry-Lite.gg. Yes, the same one with that massive link farm. I thought this one was owned by Geometry Lite, but no, they're actually blocked. And that's probably why they used to run Geometry Lite, but randomly switched to this version one day. Maybe even OneGames got sick of their aggressive marketing. The fourth site is Free Games Online, which just redirects to OneGames now. So maybe this was their way of disabling the old site. And finally, the last blocked one is Merge Fruit, which seems to be ripping off the Watermelon game. So maybe they just have beef or something. This is all to say that out of the 30 or so fake Geometry-websites you can still find on Google, 3 are blocked from using Geometry Lite, 10 are either owned by or affiliated with the creators of it, and the rest are free to embed it, which pretty much every site is doing now. But one thing that really confused me was that most of the verified websites had an ID attached to them, and a lot of them were even the same, so I decided to look up what these IDs might actually represent, and oh my god, they're AdSense IDs! And if multiple websites share the same ID, it means that all the money those sites are making is going to the same account. Now, GD.io and Geometry Free both had their own IDs, but these 5 websites, which include Geometry Lite, all shared one. I knew I had to look further into this. After all, pretty much every Geometry-website has a public AdSense ID that you could just search up. And better yet, there's tools where you can plug in one AdSense ID and see all the other websites that use them. For example, if we plug in the ID that Geometry Lite used, we can see that... No way! These guys own SkibbityToilet.io! And you know, like 40 other fake game websites? Next I tried Geometry-.io's ID, and boom, a dozen more, 3 of which were verified by OneGames. And this pattern continued until I had a list of 200 websites across just 10 AdSense accounts. It's all connected. These aren't just fake game websites that anyone can buy and host, it's a huge network controlled by one master group, probably somewhere in Vietnam, which we know from existing evidence and the fact that Geometry-.io literally has its AdSense currency set to Vietnam's. Using this master list of websites, I was able to make a lot of really interesting connections. For example, remember how the site with the link farm is blocked from Geometry Lite? Well, that shares an ID with this website, which is also blocked. And before the link farm was for Geometry-, it pointed to Retro Bowl Online, which shares an ID with this website, which is also blocked. And finally, to top it all off, Geometry-.io had an extra tag in its source code, which was only shared with one other location, OneGames, finally confirming that yes, they've always been connected. So with all this newfound information, let's go over the remaining mysteries. Question 1. Does GM Media own Geometry-.io? Well, all the evidence seems to say yes. They made Geometry Lite for their own websites so that unlike Scratch, they would have full control over the game they're hosting. Question 2. Does GM Media own those other Unity versions of Geometry Dash? Actually, we don't know this for sure. Even though there do exist 2 versions with their watermark, most sites don't run those ones. And there's still a lot of sites running the other versions like Meltdown and Bloodbath, and they don't share IDs with any websites tied to Geometry Lite, except for Slopeball, which is more of an anomaly. And let's not forget that they were developed at the same time, with almost 0 overlapping code. So it looks like the answer is no, but I bet they work for the same group, and maybe even teamed up. However, one very interesting thing I found at the last minute was that Slopeball appears on HTML5 game distribution under a company named Greenlight, and they actually have 3 more Geometry Dash games, all of which are reskins of, you guessed it, the Unity games, unlike Slopeball, which comes from GeoJump. It's actually pretty cool seeing how they rearranged the menus to be less of a blatant copy, and iconic details like the fire trail and progress bar make a return. Sub-Zero is still the weird extended version of the level that uses Geometrical Dominator, and their third game, Avatar Game, is an Avatar-themed reskin of Light that only goes up to Polargeist. And yes, it still controls like the Cube. It even has its own dedicated website, which doesn't have an AdSense ID but does follow the same styling as all the other Unity websites and Slopeball. This is all to say that even though this company is mostly connected to the Unity games, they did tamper with GeoJump as well, which GM Media made. So while I still believe these games have different developers, maybe they're comfortable sharing them around with one another. Question 3. What's the deal with the Link Farm? This one's easy. Geometry-Lite.gg wanted more clicks, so they made a pretty extreme move that ultimately backfired. We still don't know if they're actually involved with GM Media, so that's left as a maybe. Question 4. How do you make a fake game website? It seems like this is an underground business run by one big group in Vietnam. There's probably some secret ways to join in, just like how there's ways to become a tech support scammer. Question 5. Were the Geometry Lite levels built in the actual editor? Again, the way they appear in Unity makes it clear that the levels were definitely imported from somewhere and definitely not built by hand. Looking at Light, World, and Meltdown, these were almost definitely ripped from the game because even small things like the triggers and spike decorations are in the right place. And we know they've opened RobTop levels in the editor before because of that one screenshot. On the other hand, the Sub-Zero levels don't even come close and were probably too complicated to port over from the real thing. For the non-RobTop levels like Spooky and Egg Dash, it's definitely weird that they have these little decorations, but they could have easily been added last. Though I don't think they were made in the editor because of one very subtle difference. These little pulsing rods are at a slightly different Y position compared to if you place them in the real GD editor. So I personally believe that they were made in a different grid-based editor and not Geometry Dash's, but they definitely have the technology to port it, so maybe I'm just overthinking this and they use the real editor. And finally, question number 6. Who made Geometry Lite? Well, we actually have no idea, and probably won't ever know. The number one rule for these websites is to be as secret as possible. Nobody can get in contact, and nobody can know who's involved. And the same applies to the games that they make. So the best info we have is that it's someone, maybe multiple people, in a mysterious shady company known as GM Media. Sometimes they steal levels, sometimes they rearrange them, and sometimes they even build their own and do a fantastic job at it. But to the creator of these games, if you're somehow watching this, whoever you are, just know that you're way too overqualified to be working on these weird scam games, and I would love to see you pursue a game design career with less crime. Heck, maybe you could even score some creator points in the actual GD editor. But for now, you managed to make something that's both incredible and very concerning, to say the least. You've consumed several months of my life, kept me up at night countless times, and pulled me down a rabbit hole deeper than anything I've ever seen before. There was a period of my life where this version of Geometry Dash was more real to me than the actual game. And as much as I fear you, I also kind of want to thank you. Because just like me, you're crazy, and I respect that. Something tells me that immediately after I post this video, a lot is going to change. And I'm ready for that, because it feels like the only way to push this story forward. I was originally going to wait another month or two, but this has been building up inside of me for a while now, and whenever someone asks what I've been trying to solve, I don't even know where to begin. When researching this, I would find new information pretty much every day, and I'm sure there's still more to uncover. So if I find anything else, I'll leave it in the pinned comment or maybe even make a whole other video. But for now, this marks the end of the story of Geometry Lite and all of those other weird websites. One Games has clearly moved on to other stuff, and damn it, it's time that I do as well. Actually, what are they doing now? Wait, there's a third website with the tag they had. GorillaAdventure.io? Buy now on Steam? Dude, they just dropped Guerrilla Adventure on Steam! It's still just a shameless getting over it clone that you can play on their website for free, but damn, the Guerrilla Adventure lore goes crazy! This is it. This is what the video's been building up to. All that Geometry Lite stuff, it was just to prepare you for this masterpiece of a game. If you made it through this whole video, that's kind of terrifying, but also, thank you. Hope you enjoyed my descent into madness, subscribe for more stuff like this, avoid playing Geometry Lite without an ad blocker if you can, and honestly, the next time you're looking for a good online Geometry Dash game, maybe just stick to Scratch.